Well, hello, little lambs between the ages of 7 and 9. Your teachers are excited to spend some time with you, and I hope you are too. Here's Sunday School.
Welcome back, City Kids. I've missed you. Welcome to a brand new day. This is the day that the Lord has made. Let us rejoice and be glad indeed. I'm super excited about today's lesson. But before we start, let's get into a nice song. Wait. You guys look sleepy. Before we get into that song, come, let's do some warm-ups. Let's do some rollies. Come. Move your body one way. And then move it in the middle. And then come to the side. Now you're ready. Come, let's get into that song, and I'll see you in a bit. That song so precious, talking about God's love for us. I love it. And now we're gonna have my special friend take us through our virtues and our pledges.
I pledge as a City Kid to behave as Jesus Christ would at all times, to listen to authority, to be bold and talk to everyone about Jesus Christ, to learn one memory verse a week, to respect and help others. The virtues of a City Kid are honesty, respect, compassion, and responsibility.
Now, before we get into our word, let's start off with some prayer. Everybody, please close your eyes. Heavenly Father, we thank you for this day. We thank you for each and every little boy and girl that is sitting listening to your word. May your word bear fruit in Jesus' name. Amen. Do you know what I realized that I actually forgot? We forgot to say a special shout out to God today to celebrate Father's Day. So what I want you guys to do, I want the girls to blow kisses to Jesus, and I want the boys to do a whole whoop 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 whoop. Okay, can we do that in 3, 2, 1? Whoop 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 whoop. God, we love you and we celebrate you today. You are an awesome father. We're gonna kick off with our memory verse. So our memory verse comes from the book of Proverbs, chapter 22, verse 6. And it goes, train a child in the way he should go. Okay, in the way he should go. And when he is old, he will not depart from it. Okay, let's do that again. Train a child in the way he should go. And when he is old, he will not depart from it. What do you think that means? Basically means that if you focus on the Word of God every single day, do you think when you're older, you're just gonna forget about it? Never. Because the Word of God will be nicely tucked away in your heart, and you'll never forget the promises of God, and you'll always love your life walking with Jesus. And that's something that we need to aspire to every single day, spending time in God's beautiful presence. Okay, I'm going to teach you guys about the prodigal son. This boy, he does the most in the story. But you know what? There's a beautiful lesson in it. The parable, basically, let me explain before we start, is a parable are teachings that Jesus would actually teach his disciples to teach them a specific lesson. So there's a lesson that God wants us to know about the prodigal son. So get your Bibles, I have mine, and you need to turn to the book of Luke, chapter 15, and we would read from verse 11 to 24. Are you ready? I'm about to begin. Jesus continued, "There was a man who had two sons. The younger one said to his father, 'Father, give me my share of the estate.' So he divided his property between them. Not long after that, the younger son got together all he had, set off for a distant country, and there squandered his wealth in wild living. After he had spent everything, there was severe famine in that whole country, and he began to be in need. So he went and hired himself out to a citizen of that country, who sent him to his fields to feed pigs. He longed to fill his stomach with the pods that the pigs were eating, but no one gave him anything. When he came to his senses, he said, 'How many of my father's hired men have food to spare? And here I am starving to death. I will set out and go back to my father and say to him, "Father, I have sinned against heaven and against you. I am no longer to be called your son. Make me like one of your hired men." So he got up and went to his father. But while he was a long way off, his father saw him and was filled with compassion for him. And he ran to his son, threw his arms around him and kissed him. The son said to him, "Father, I have sinned against heaven and against you. I'm no longer worthy to be called your son." But the father said to his servant, "Quick, bring the best robe and put it on him. Put on a ring on his finger and sandals on his feet. Bring the fattened calf and kill it. Let's have a feast and celebrate. For this son of mine was dead and is alive again. He was lost and is found." So they began to celebrate. That story gives me goosebumps because it just talks about the beautiful love of Jesus. But let me explain the story to you. Okay. So this man had two sons. And he gave them an estate, which means that he gave them a lot of money. So the one son had his money and the other son had his pocket of money. So when the other son got his money, do you know what he did? "Dad, I'm out of here." And he packed his bag. And he's like, "I'm gonna go spend all my money, 'cause now I'm rich." Imagine, he didn't even think about helping his father at the farm, at his estate. He was like, "I'm gonna leave and I'm gonna squander this money." So he was living large, getting himself all forms of things and spending money on PlayStations, new Jordans. He was spending money on getting as many ice creams, all things that just didn't even matter. And then what happened? The money ran dry. And guess who was hungry? He had left his father. And now he was so embarrassed now because now he's so hungry. He decided, you know what? Let me go get a job. So he went to go work for a man who had a pig farm. Do you know, it was so bad. He was so poor to a point that he even considered eating the pig's food. Imagine, would you want to eat pig's food? And then he thought about all the people that worked for his father that were eating all those amazing, delicious food. While he was there in these tattered clothes, like he was dirty, he was hungry, and he decided, you know what? I'm gonna go back to my dad. I'm gonna ask for forgiveness. And even if it means that I must just work for him, I'm gonna ask to get a job because I don't feel like I'm deserving to be his son. So he set off first thing in the morning to go off now to his father's, father's estate. So off he went in his heart thinking, "Oh my goodness, I feel so bad for what I've done. I should have not done what I did." And when he saw his father, guess what his father did? His father ran to him because he hadn't seen his son for so long and he thought his son was probably dead. And he hugged him and he kissed him. And you know what else he said? He said to his servants, come bring a robe, which means get your best bomber jacket or get your best dazzly jacket, you know, for my child. Get him the best sneakers, you know, get the best stuff for him. My son is back. I'm so happy. But it didn't stop there. Do you know what he said to him too? Because you're back, we're gonna celebrate. So there they were. Party mood, announcements. It was hectic. Like, they had such an amazing time. And if you think about this, can you think about a point in your life where you thought that, you know, your parents were probably like not forgive you if you did something? So I'll give you an example. When I was young, I used to love the mall, and I used to tell my dad and my mom, don't hold my hand, I'm fine. So there I was walking in the mall, looking at one shop to the other, thinking I'm so grown. And then guess what happened? I realized that I was lost. I didn't know where they were, and I started crying. But you know what is happening on the other end? My mom and dad were also worried sick because they had no idea where I was. And I was crying, thinking I was so wrong to not allow them to hold my hand. And I was thinking to myself, they're going to give me the smack of my life. And I was so scared. But also, I just wanted to go home. I wanted to see my mom again. I just missed her hugs. And I just wanted to be able to see my dad. And then luckily, there was a security guard who found me, and he helped me find my mom and dad. And you know, when they saw me, like, they just hugged me, and they're like, we're so glad we found you. We were so worried about you. And you know how hot, like, how full my heart felt at that point, knowing that, firstly, phew, I am not gonna get a smack. And two, the love that my parents felt for me. It made my entire day, and I felt so relieved. And this is the lesson that I want you to know about God's love, is that even we can make the worst decisions over and over and over again, but the goodness of Jesus is that his arms are like this all the time. When you're thinking, oh, he probably doesn't want me today, oh, I did the worst thing, his arms are like this. I just want to make you better. I just want you to make you feel better. I love you. Come back to me. You know, you're my child. You're my baby. And there's nothing in the world that you can say or do that can make you love you any less. So I will love you on your best day. I will love you on your worst day. And that's the goodness of Jesus, is that if we tell him and we confess our sins, like the lesson we learned the last time, is that he's so quick to forgive us. He doesn't say, how many things did you do wrong today? No. Every time you say, I am so sorry, Lord, he is quick to forgive us. You know, you could have, I don't know, like, what do you guys? You could have painted your bedroom like a neon color, and your mom, like, probably was like, what did you do to my house? Just as quickly as your mom would forgive you, God will do the same. Actually, God will forgive you even quicker, you know, than your mom would. Because your mom would be thinking, oh my goodness, how am I going to fix this? But God just sees you, and he just sees love. He looks at you, and he's like, he's looking at his adoring baby, and he's just thinking, it's okay to make mistakes. It's okay to fail. As long as you remember that you can always come back to me. And that's the beautiful lesson that we want to understand today, is that God's love, God's forgiveness, and that we can always come to our Father because he will forgive us. Because he loves us just that much. And nothing in this world can keep you away from God. God wants you to himself. You are his special child. You are made in his image. I really hope you enjoyed today's lesson. I loved it. And that's a beautiful reminder that in everything that we can do, we still have God's love. Have a blessed Sunday. And thank you so much for joining us. Bye.
Thank you for joining the City of Zion online Sunday morning service with Pastor Tim Grage. We look forward to hosting you again next week at 9 a.m. And please do tune in for our live daily devotionals Monday to Friday at 8 a.m. on Facebook at Tim Morfay Grage. For your tithes and offering, here are the banking details. Please note that your heartfelt giving to the kingdom in the season aid the many struggling financially at this time, and so we thank you for your generosity. The City of Zion offers online Sunday school. If you have doves between the ages of 3 and 6, lambs between the ages of 7 and 9, or eagles between the ages of 10 and 12, we encourage you to join us at The City of Zion on YouTube for our Sunday classes at 10:30 a.m. Now, while church may be closed, our doors and our hearts are wide open. If you're in need of prayer, please don't hesitate to reach out to us at prayerrequest@thecoz.org.